DAP politician Teresa Kok today filed a suit at the Kuala Lumpur High Court against Home Minister and three others for unlawful arrest and forced imprisonment last year. The suit was filed by her lawyer Sankara Nair at the court registry this morning.
Orang nak masuk, itu semua macam nak tangkap gangster je. That is not right.
Kok, the Member of Parliament for Seputeh and Kinrara State Assemblyperson, named Home Minister Syed Hamid Albar, Inspector General Police Musa Hassan, Arresting Officer DSP E Kim Tien and the Malaysian Government as defendants. She claimed that she was wrongfully arrested and detained under the Internal Security Act last year. In her statement of claim, Kok said that she was arrested by the defendants at the entrance to her residence at Perth Tower, OG Heights at 11:15 PM on September 12 last year.
Okay, this is the suit filed by a lawyer, Mr. Sankara Nair, to seek damages against
the government
of Malaysia.
That is
Teresa Hamid, Menteri Dalam Negeri, Ketua Polis Negara Tan Sri Musa bin Hassan, and also the DSP E Kim Tien, who arrested me in front of my condo, and also the Malaysian government. So, I think we have waited long enough. Ever since I came out from the ISA arrest, I really say that I wanted to really file a suit against the Malaysian government and the police for arresting me under the ISA without, you know, they arrested me for me is
without reasons.
So, then they asked for, after we have filed the letter of demand, they have requested for how many days?
Still today we haven't had a reply.
Requested for time.
And then they never replied.
And they never replied until today. So I think it's really time for me to take legal action against the Malaysian government and also Malaysian police for putting me under the ISA.
And the worst part is at the end of the day, the minister as well as the IGP get that, no case.
Like my ISA arrest actually showed to the members of public that ISA is actually a law that can be abused easily by the government. So if I that's why all this while we have been campaigning to repeal this draconian law that I have made. I have waited long enough, I think half a year, close to half a year, for the Malaysian government, for PDRF, to give me an explanation on my arrest. So but for the last half a year, I didn't receive any letter of reply for the letter of demand issued by my lawyer to them. So I think, it's really time for me to file this legal action against CDRM and also the Malaysian government.